Now, a second environmental story on a much larger scale. Scientists have warned frequently that we need to stop the planet from warming an additional 2 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels to avoid catastrophic problems. A new analysis of temperature data by the Washington Post finds many major areas across the United States have reached or are already nearing that 2-degree mark. It also found significant variations across the country. Chris Mooney from the Washington Post is here to lay out how some parts of the U.S. are being impacted more than others. Chris, welcome to the NewsHour.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
It's a sweeping analysis looking across decades and decades of data. Tell me how you came to know what you know.
We set out to just look at some hints that I'd seen in scientific studies and other places about some parts of the globe warming much faster than others, and there being some impacts, strange or dramatic, in these places. And we said, can we look at this more widely? And sure enough, we can. NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, has a great complete data set for the United States down to the county level, back to 1895, all the way through. So that's what we looked at, and sure enough, there are hot spots across the lower 48 states. Alaska is another story. It's actually warming even more. But across the lower 48, there are some dramatic areas.
Okay, before we get to Alaska, let's look at that separately. But what did you find across the lower 48? Are there patterns?
Yes. So one of the most striking patterns is the northern border of the country, from roughly Montana all the way to Maine, is repeatedly high levels of warming compared to what's below it. And if you were to look at Canada, you would see that continuing. So it's something about northern land areas were warming faster. We think this has something to do probably with the winter season and when snow is melting faster than the bare ground is exposed and it's absorbing more solar radiation. This is a process that scientists think will play out under climate change. And given that we're seeing this pattern having to do with the north, then we suspect that's what it is. There's some other hot spots as well, but that's one of the biggest patterns.
And what is it that you're actually seeing on the ground? I mean, temperature data is one thing, but what does that 1 or 2 degree Celsius change mean on the ground?
We looked at New Jersey the most closely because New Jersey is about 1.9 Celsius, and so Rhode Island is actually 2. It's the fastest warming in the lower 48, New Jersey's second. We went to a lake in New Jersey, Lake Opatcong, and it's really kind of a great way to tell the story because 100 years ago, this was sort of this winter wonderland where people would, they would ice skate, they would ice fish, they had giant winter carnivals and skaters and ice boats, ice sailing. And plus, it was an ice factory, and they chopped up the ice. There was so much of it to ship it to New York because there were no refrigerators. So they would use the ice to keep things cold for large numbers of people. And now, the lake is, it's very hard to even hold ice fishing contests anymore. The lake is overgrowing with weeds that are being sort of helped along by the warmer temperatures, and it just had a dangerous algal bloom, which also occurs more frequently when temperatures rise. So it's a giant change has happened.
It's a giant change you're seeing that's clear when you look at numbers, right, over 100 plus years. Yeah. Well, what about people on the ground? Have they been noticing a change too?
Oh, absolutely. And so you go to Lake Opatcong, and you say, what happened? They say, we don't have those winters anymore. You know, we cannot do the pastimes. You know, the ice fishing, that's just not, it's not something that's very easy to do. Some years you still can do it because weather varies a great deal. Mm-hmm. But across New Jersey, winter has changed the fastest, and you see all these effects related to winter. So one of the things that happens is, you know, you get different growth of weeds in the lake. You get pests that used to die because the winter was too cold for them. They now come up and visit new places. And so you have the Pine Barrens of New Jersey is infested with the southern pine beetle, which is destroying pine trees. And it's not clear how they will stop that from occurring. And so that's very destructive. You have ticks moving. This is a phenomenon that's occurring throughout the Northeast. And, you know, a lot of agricultural pests are on the move. So a lot of big changes.
So across all of these hotspots you mentioned, Alaska stands out to you. Is that it's been warming faster than any other part?
Sure.
What are you seeing there?
It's the Arctic, right? The Arctic is in a class of its own. Mm-hmm. What people are surprised to learn is that it's actually in the lower 48. We sort of knew the Arctic, so Alaska is 2.2 Celsius as an average is what we found based on interviewing experts about Alaska. But there's parts of Alaska, like the North Slope, that are way, way above that.
You also note in your article that global warming does not apply itself evenly, right? Not across the globe, certainly not in the U.S. So are there parts of America that basically don't feel this at all?
Yeah, the South stands out as not having warmed over this 124-year period much at all. And even in Mississippi and Alabama, some slight cooling. It's really surprising. It's a complicated story that has to do with air pollution in the middle of the century and maybe some natural variability of the climate. And then they actually are warming the last 50 years, but that gets outweighed by the prior part of the period, so they end up with nothing. So it's a variable picture.
So just within this one country, right, there's two very different stories when it comes to how people are experiencing climate change, global warming. How do you think that affects how we have a national conversation about this?
I mean, it is difficult because it'll affect people's perceptions in a lot of different ways. On the other hand, what we found is that, you know, because there's 71 counties that are above 2C and some of them are very populated, we've got 10% of the population in those counties. So it's a national story. The impacts are going to be playing out in a lot of regions. We've got Rocky Mountain region, we've got Southern California, we've got this whole northern stretch. It affects a lot of different regions, just not evenly. So I think that it is the United States as a whole that needs to be paying attention to it, not just some parts of it.
That's a fascinating report. It's stunning in how sweeping it is, and it's available at the Washington Post right now. Chris Mooney, thank you so much for being here.
Great to be with you.